Okay, welcome to this practical session regarding the oral cavity anatomy. You know the oral cavity is the part of digestive system, the first part of the digestive system, composed externally from the opening surrounded by the two lips, upper lip and lower lip. Tamam? And around this lips you have what is called the orbicularis oculi muscle, sphincteric muscle of the muscles of the face. So this is the orbicularis oculi muscle making most of the bulk of the upper and lower limb. The upper and lower limb lips, this is the grayish, the pinkish colored part of your lips, is a mucous membrane actually. So the line between mucous membrane covering the lips and the skin is a mucocutaneous demarcation, which is present. For example, in the anal region, you have also mucocutaneous demarcation, and also at the even at the conjunctiva as a mucous membrane, and so on. Okay. So the oral cavity, if you have a look to this plastic model, closed oral cavity and the closed upper and lower jaw, you can see this is a space here between the cheeks and the closed upper and lower jaw. We call it a vestibule. So the vestibule is a space just around the oral cavity, outside the closed upper and lower jaw. So the space here inside the closed upper and lower jaw, we call it the oral cavity proper, occupied mainly by this bulky muscular structure, the tongue, you know. And this is the roof of the oral cavity, which is the palate, we call it the palate. Again, the closed lips, we have upper and lower lips, closing the mouth or the opening of the oral cavity. And here we have the two jaws, are the upper and lower jaws are closed together, and these are the teeth. And you can see or imagine this is the space outside the closed upper and lower jaw. Just around the two jaw, two sides, you can see a horseshoe or U-shaped space outside the closed mandible and maxilla. We call it the vestibule. And the vestibule is the space communicates posteriorly with the oral cavity proper behind the last molar tooth. The last molar tooth, you can imagine we have a space communicate between the oral cavity proper and the vestibule. Now the mouth as a space here is the space bounded between the roof and the floor. So the roof of the oral cavity is the heart, the palate, and the palate is composed of bony part more anterior and soft part more posterior. So we call it the heart palate, formed by bones. These are the palatine process of the maxilla bone, more anterior, and the palatine bone. The palatine bone more posterior, they are united together from right side and left side, forming this bony plate, forming the heart palate. The heart palate is covered on the oral side by the mucous membrane, which is squamous in type epithelium. Squamous is more resistant to the physical injury, like during mastication, the hard objects in the food, for example, should be needs more resistant epithelium type, like the squamous. On the superior part of the heart palate, we have the respiratory epithelium. You know that, which is the ciliated, pseudostratified ciliated epithelium. Now, the soft palate is composed by the core of muscles here, uvulo musculus muscle in the center, and when the in the lateral side, from right and left side, you will have muscles called palati muscle, or we call it two types: tensor villi palati muscle and levator villi palati muscle. They are elevating the uvula, which is the soft palate here, to close the passage between the nasal pharynx and the oropharynx. Again, we have hard palate by the bones, and we have soft palate by the muscles, and covered by mucous membrane. We call it the uvula in the center of your oral cavity. Here is the opening. You can imagine this is the opening. We call it the oropharyngeal isthmus. So the oral cavity communicate with the external environment through the oral opening, which is the mouth opening, and posteriorly communicate with the pharynx, with the oropharynx, what is called, this is the oropharyngeal isthmus. It is the narrower part of the oral cavity. When we pass it from the oral cavity proper into the oropharynx. Okay? And the oropharyngeal isthmus is just bounded by the uvula, more superior, the epiglottis more posterior, and the palatoglossal folds on each side. Palatoglossal fold on each side. Now, regarding this bulky muscle, which is the tongue, is composed of two types of muscles, the intrinsic type muscle and extrinsic. The intrinsic, they are a group of fibers, bundles of fibers, إما تكون بشكل longitudinal أو تكون transversely, يعني crossing transversely from right side to left side. These muscles, if they are contracted, will change the shape of the tongue, while the extrinsic muscle coming from outside the tongue, for example, from the mandible, genial glossus, from the stylo glossus, from the hyoid, hyoglossus, and so on. And these are moving the tongue as a whole, yani as a whole, moving it, whether protruding or retracting or elevating or depressing. So a difference between these two group of muscles, sorry. Okay, so again, the roof of the mouth is the hard and soft palate, while the floor of the mouth is the myelohyoid muscle, which is a flat sheet of muscle forming diaphragm, separating the oral cavity from the outside, which is the neck, most probably. So the myelohyoid is a sheet of muscle attaching to the myelohyoid line on the inside of the mandible. Please give me this mandible. This is the mandible, you can see it. This is the red line, we call it the myelohyoid line for the attachment of the muscle. So the area here is outside the oral cavity proper. And the area here is the oral cavity. So the diaphragm, we call it the myelohyoid, is the separating sheet between the outside the oral cavity from the inside of the oral cavity. Now, the myelohyoid is the line of insertion attachment of the myelohyoid muscle from this side and that side, and they are inserted in the midline by what is called a midline raphe. I think you have, you can يعني see it somewhere. ما موجود هنا بس you can imagine this white line, it is the midline insertion between this muscle from right side from the other half on the left side. مع بعضهم they have no bony insertion, they have only lateral attachment to the myelohyoid line on the bone, on the mandible, بينما بالmidline يصير بهم insertion by this is what we call the myelohyoid raphe in the midline. Okay, we will shift to the real cadaveric demonstration. You can imagine this is the oral cavity for the male one, and you can see this is the lower lip and the upper lip. When we close it, we will close the oral cavity. The area here between the lips or the cheeks on lateral side, for example here, this is the vestibule. What we meant by vestibule, the space outside the closed jaw, whether upper jaw or even lower jaw. So I put my forceps inside the vestibule now, okay? Now you can imagine this is the roof of the oral cavity, the heart palate, I can feel it. This is a bony sensation here, covered by mucosa, and the soft palate, it is the area here. I just catch it. This is the uvula, حقيقة. This is the uvula midline. هذا كله هو soft palate, اللي هو مفروض بي muscles, covered by mucosa on the oral side by the digestive mucosa, and on the nasal side by the respiratory mucosa. The mouth is playing here inside your oral cavity, where you can imagine it. It is a bulky muscle composed of intrinsic part muscle, sorry, and extrinsic. Before that, the tongue is composed of two portions. We have anterior two-thirds, we call it the buccal part of the tongue, the buccal part, because this is the buccal cavity, buccal part, the anterior two-thirds, and the posterior one-third, اللي هو يسمونه pharyngeal part, على اعتبار هو بالأوروفارنكس. I'm cutting now the palatoglossal fold, which is the part of oropharyngeal isthmus separating between oral cavity and that oropharynx. إذا هذا هو الحد الفاصل ما بين this is the oropharynx and this is the space we call it the oral cavity. إذا the tongue, the posterior third of the tongue is inside the oropharynx. The posterior third of the tongue inside the oropharynx. And you can imagine we have just like a V shape arrangement here, V shape. You can see these are papillae, valid papillae 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. And on the other side we have two rows here and here, just like V shape. And the V shape is called sulcus terminalis, separated between the anterior 2/3, اللي هو بالبوكال part, from the posterior 1/3 in the pharyngeal part. On the top of this V shape, on the top, on the apex, we can imagine a depression here. This is the depression here, which is what is called the foramen cecum. So when I put my, for example, pen and label this area, we call it the foramen cecum. When the foramen cecum is the beginning of what is called the thyroglossal duct or a tract, which is the tract taken by the developing descending thyroid gland for the anterior part of the neck. So the tongue, مثل ما قلنا, be two-third anterior, 1/3 posterior. هذا هو palatoglossal fold. If you dissect it, you can see a muscle here. We call it palatoglossus muscle, which is muscle of the tongue supplied by pharyngeal branch of vagus. All the muscles of the tongue are supplied by hypoglossal nerve, except this muscle present inside this fold, اللي هي palatoglossus muscle supplied by pharyngeal branch of vagus nerve. The area here, you can say it, this is the frenulum, for example, at the tip of the tongue, at the frenulum. The appearance of the tongue is a fluffy. Because we have many villi on the surface of the tongue. They are useful for taste and also for mixing the food particles together during the process of mastication that happens inside the oral cavity. Okay? Come on. We will try to go somewhat outside the oral cavity. Okay, شباب لحد الآن؟ تمام. Now we are seeing the submandibular region, which is outside the mylohyoid muscle, so we are outside the oral cavity. Simply, you can see it on the plastic model, just to be oriented. This is the tongue, this is the mandible cut, okay? And this is the mylohyoid muscle, which is the floor of the mouth. So here we are inside the oral cavity, and you can see the gland here, sublingual gland, under the cover of the mucosa of the oral cavity, and the submandibular gland, which is the two portion, superficial portion outside the mylohyoid, and the deep portion inside the mylohyoid. Here we have this, the posterior belly of digastric, this is the anterior belly of digastric, outside the mylohyoid muscle. We will try to make the cadaver model just like resembling this picture. So the mandible is here. The mandible, this is the oral cavity, shabab. The mandible is here. I'm reflecting the skin and subcutaneous tissue. okay? And this is the muscle, which is the mylohyoid muscle. This one, شباب. هذا الشيت الاني ماسكه. هذا هو المايلوهايود مسل. هذا الوسط اللي هو ميد لاين رافي. هذا تشوفوا تقريبا نوعا ما تيز وايتش ان كلر. اكو فايبرس تيشو. So this is the right portion. This is the left portion. So this is the mylohyoid muscle. So now here we are outside the oral cavity. If you go more superficial, we are inside the oral cavity. So the muscle here, they are genioglossus muscle. هذا ribbon-like muscle. Ribbon-like muscle, this and that. These are genioglossus muscle because the tongue is here. The base of the tongue is here. Now we are at the level of the base of the tongue, okay? هنا نشوف انت tongue, the more superficial part of it, اللي هو movable inside the oral cavity. Now the base of the tongue, the root of the tongue, انه هنا موجود, okay? So again, هذا هي المسل, we call it the mylohyoid muscle. هذا كأنما هي sheet of muscle. And outside it, we have what is called the digastric muscle. This is the anterior belly on the left side, طبعا. Right side, هنا أعتقد, I think this is the one, هاي ال digastric muscle. يمكن يعني is يعني avulsed, مقطوعة. They are more external to the mylohyoid muscle. So digastric muscle, mylohyoid muscle, and now we are inside the oral cavity. This is, these are the genioglossus muscle from the tubercle and the mandible toward the tongue, okay? You can see this is the superficial part of the submandibular gland. I'm cut it between my fingers, okay? Here you can imagine this is the duct. I will show you. Just wait for me. حتى أرتب لكم ال structures. تحاول تساعدني بس بهذا باللي left hand. امسك لي على الطريقة هاي. لا لا بحده هذا.
تمام.
Okay. خشي خليه تمام. شباب. هسه رجعت ليا. Okay. واضحة ما ادري اشوف حقيقة امور طيبة. لا انت لا تحرك الكاميرا، احنا نحرك نفسنا الكاميرا، خليها ثابتة. لا خليها ثابتة. ما تفيدني ايش متحركها ويصير فيها زوم يعني فيلينغ. افضل يا اخي. الموبايل شباب هاي الجلاند سوبرفيشال بارت طبعا الديب بارت از يعني ريموفد مو ريموفد انه كات لانه الدايسكشن شويه يعني اجريسيف. This is the what is called the lingual nerve. Sorry اشيل ايدك شيل ايدك شكرا lingual nerve. This is the gland. هذا hypoglossal nerve شباب. Hypoglossal nerve motor for the tongue. And here you have the lingual nerve, which is a branch of trigeminal, okay? The nerve carrying with it the parasympathetic supply called tympani, okay, to the submandibular gland. So the communication between the nerve with the gland is here. بالضبط هنا هاي المنطقة الماسكة آني. It contains the submandibular ganglia. Submandibular ganglia, which is a parasympathetic ganglia, receiving the preganglionic fiber from the facial, called tympani, toward the gland, حتى يصير secretomotor fibers. Then the area here is the what is called the submandibular ganglia, receiving the fibers from the lingual nerve. The lingual nerve is a sensory for the anterior two-thirds of the tongue, وبالتالي يتقسم إلى يعني branches there. Okay. الهايبرغلوسال نيرف اللي هو هذا is a motor for the tongue, except the muscle we call it the palatoglossus muscle, supplied by pharyngeal branch of the vagus. Okay. حقيقة a lot of structures موجودين هنا لكنهم كلهم مقطعين. We cannot say this is a facial nerve or lingual nerve. Sorry, vein. لكنه خلينا نتبع الأشياء الواضحة والموجودة. These are the muscles of the يعني oral cavity. إذن submandibular gland موجودة مع ال lingual nerve, submandibular ganglia, hypoglossal nerve. I think this is the most. This is the duct of the gland. بس لكنه cut حقيقة. The duct of the gland mostly passing there, and the lingual nerve. هو المفروض يصير winding around coming from the lateral side and then winding around the duct. لكنه حقيقة relations هنا مفقودة لأنه the nerves are cut يعني فمتحركة براحتها يعني. إذن as a summary, we have the mandible here, the muscles تكلمنا عليهم هاي المايلوهايود. We have outside it, we have the digastric muscle. Inside you have genioglossus and these structures, humolingual nerve, the duct and the hypoglossal nerve. Okay. The gland. Okay. لما نوصل الجلاند من جوا ينطي الفايبرز باتجاه الانجلي فتتفوت باتجاه الجلاند تسوي سكريتوموتر. هو يكمل طريقه باتجاه التانك تمام ويتفرع الى برانشز for the anterior two third of the tongue. General sensation, pain and temperature. طبعا طبعا هو يخدم معاه خلاص بدك بس مجرد يوصلها. اي كور تمبني. ال relations مالت ال lingual nerve مع ال duct هو انه يبدا ال nerve outside عفوا external to the duct اول شيء ثم يسوي winding around هيك ويصير deep to the duct يعني بالبدايه هو outside the duct, external to the duct, and then winding around from below, we see it again medial in it. لأنه الدكت تروح باتجاه السبلينجوال ميوكوزا تفتح.